Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. In today's video, episode 17 of the Kasparov series. It's 1980 and Kasparov is playing for Russia in the Chess Olympiads in Malta. Russia arrives in Malta with a super team: Karpov, Polugaevsky, Tal, Geller, Balashov and the young Garry Kasparov. But once again, the defending champions Hungary proved to be a real match for the Soviet favorites. The Hungarians led the tournament until the last round, but in the end the two teams tied for first place. The Soviet Union, with a slightly better tiebreak score, won the gold medals. I also have a couple of nice old photos to show you. In the first one there is Karpov, Tal smoking as usual, and also playing against a young dandy. Can you recognize this beloved grandmaster? Is the great Yasser Seirawan from St. Louis Chess Club. In the other photo, unfortunately with a bad resolution, there is our Garry Kasparov. Now let's go back to our video. The game that we are going to watch is Kasparov versus Marjanovic, played in round 4. A fantastic attacking game against the Queen's Indian. Let's get started. Garry Kasparov with the white pieces opens with d4. Marjanovic answers with knight to f6, now c4, e6, knight to f3, and with b6 we are in the Queen's Indian. g3, bishop to b7, and bishop to g2, now bishop to e7, short castle for white, and short castle for black. This is the old main line, but now Kasparov, instead of simply developing with knight to c3, plays an interesting move introduced just a few months before by Polugaevsky in his candidate's win against Korchnoi. So here comes d5, that is a pawn sacrifice, he captures on d5, and now knight to h4, pins the pawn because there is the unprotected bishop here on b7. So here comes c6, protecting the pawn and closing this diagonal. C captures, knight captures, and now knight to f5, attacking the bishop. What to do now? Korchnoi, in order to save the bishop pair, played bishop to c5. This is just a variation that I like to show you because it's very interesting and we can understand the idea behind this pawn sacrifice. This bishop to c5 was not played by Marjanovic, but let's watch what happens after Korchnoi plays bishop to c5. Here comes e4 with tempo, knight back to e7, and now knight captures on g7. This is the real intention of knight to f5. The king, of course, captures on g7. Here comes b4. This bishop is trapped, must capture. Bishop captures on b4, and now queen to d4 we check. The bishop, of course, is lost. Now f6 must be played to close because black must close this long diagonal at all cost, because there is also bishop to b2 with the checkmate threat. Now queen captures on b4, and evaluating this position, we can say that white sacrificed a pawn for the bishop pair and a better position, also a better king safety. So really an interesting idea by Polugaevsky. But going back to our game, after knight to f5, Marjanovic plays something better than bishop to c5. He continues with knight back to c7. Now, with this move, black doesn't give e4 with tempo. The bishop is still on e7, so there is not b4 with tempo, and this bishop cannot conquer this long diagonal. So knight to c7, much better than bishop to c5. And Garry Kasparov, so continues with knight to c3. Here comes d5, good move, e4, and now bishop to f6. Another good move by Marjanovic. But what happens if black simply captures here on e4? Let's go back to e4. Let's watch what happens if black captures on e4. After d captures on e4, among the many good moves that white can play, there is queen to g4 with the checkmate threat on g7, that seems to me the best line for white. Here comes g6, but of course closing the file, but now this pawn is pinned. Rook to d1, attacking the queen, and this is a good move because black must answer with knight to d5, and also the knight becomes pinned. Let's go back one move. Now in this position, the queen is protecting the bishop under attack of the knight, and but can't move to e8, because if queen to e8, there is bishop to h6, and this exchange is lost, and also the game is lost. So, very nice idea. After knight to d5, there is bishop captures on e4, and white in this position is better, because the initiative begins to be strong. Let's go back to our game. So that's why after e4, Marjanovic doesn't capture and continues with bishop to f6. So now e captures on d5, the c pawn recaptures on d5, and now bishop to f4. Knight in b goes to a6, because we must remember that black has this queen side to develop, and there is still this problem of the d5 pawn that is still pinned, because the bishop is still unprotected. Now, rook to e1, and here comes queen to d7, connecting the rooks, but this natural move is a mistake. Black should solve as soon as possible this problem of the bishop. That's why knight to c5, protecting this bishop, seems the best move, the best idea. Now, after queen to d7, here comes bishop to h3, that is attacking the queen, threatening, of course, this discovery check, knight to h6 we check, that wins the queen. So, in this position, black should understand that this queen to d7 is a mistake, must accept to lose the tempo and bring back the queen to d8. Instead, here comes king to h8, that seems to save the queen, because now there is not the discovery anymore, because the bishop is unprotected, but this king to d8 is the final mistake. Here comes knight to e4, a new piece joining the attack, attacking the bishop. Now that this bishop is not on g2 anymore, but this d5 pawn is now pinned to the queen. So bishop captures on b2, also threatening the rook, but knight to g5 is now protecting the bishop, and so any discovery is good to win the queen. Queen to c6 brings the queen away from the discovered attack, but now it's too late. Here comes knight to e7 with tempo, also this knight is controlling the only square where the king could move, so the king cannot move anymore, the queen is under attack. Queen to f6 and knight captures on h7 is the crushing move. Now this is a fork. If the king captures the knight not played by Marjanovic, let's watch what happens. If now king captures on h7 is already a forced checkmate. There is queen to h5 we check, the king cannot move. Queen to h6, only possible move. Bishop to f5 first. g6 can't be played or there is checkmate in one. King to h8, bishop captures. g6 now attacking the queen. Simply queen back to h4. Bishop back to g7. But now there is bishop to g5 we check. Only move is the bishop interference. Queen captures on h6 is a simple checkmate. So let's go back to our game. Knight captures on h7 with a fork, opens the castle and the king is naked. Queen to d4 to save the queen, trying to change the queens that of course Kasparov refused. Queen to h5, protecting the knight with the terrible discovered checkmate. So here comes g6 attacking the queen. Queen back to h4, like in the variation that we just watched. Bishop captures on a1, doesn't solve any problem, because here comes knight to f6, discovery check, and Marjanovic resigns, because it's a checkmate in 2. Let's give checkmate. King to g7, only possible move. Knight to f5, the king cannot move. G captures on f5 is forced. Now, queen to h6, with the queen also defending the knight. And this is checkmate. Guys, this game amazed me and scared me, because it shows how great is Kasparov attacking vision. Almost from nothing, he was able to bring all of his pieces against the enemy king and give checkmate to a strong opponent like Marjanovic. He made in 25 moves at the Olympic Games. This is an Olympic miniature by Garry Kasparov. Our analysis ends here. I hope that you really liked the game, and if you did, please don't forget to like the video and to subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much for watching and see you tomorrow. Goodbye!